Today we face the monsters that are at our door and bring the fight to them. Today we are canceling the apocalypse.
Hello, and welcome to Plebpla. This is the third, and the final, the end, the finale of the Pacific Rim High Grade Gunpla series. Gunpla. Plama? Call it what you will. Today is the final, and strangely, the first one of these that I had picked up way back when I bought my Deep Striker. This is the high grade Obsidian Fury. Behold. As is tradition, you get and instructions on one side. The other side, black and white, of course. And something to be noted is that each one of these kits advertises the assembly process closely resembles the manufacturing process of a Jaeger. So I'm unsure if that means the way that the pieces fit together, the way that the pieces are designed as a piece, or I'm always one that's curious about how things are made. So does that mean the first part when making a Jaeger, is it more like this? Or kind of did you start with the neck as the base? Very curious. I like to think it might be the piece separation that is the key in that statement. But let's talk about the model itself. It is the tallest of the boys. Even standing without the base, it is not but a few centimeters shorter than Gypsy Avenger standing on a base. And supported, maybe a millimeter off. The head has a lot of move around, and it's the only one that can get that Exorcist twist in there, and I said it right this time. However, while it does have I like the way the shoulder moves. The shoulder moves, that's so cool. And then when you have it resting, you just kind of fit everything back in together. It's sleek, it's great. Unfortunately, you don't get much of an arm, and you're blocked. You do get blocked. You can get it all the way, you can get the hand all the way up, but you're blocked. You do get a double-jointed elbow, though, which is always good. At the waist, you get some turn at, the pelvis, but then you get, the ab crunch. This is the ab crunchiest. Now the reason it doesn't turn at the back is because it has a simulated spine. That's also very cool detailing that I really like. The legs, once again, your boy goes all the way up to kick himself in the teeth. Oh, your arm is in the way, sir. And a full double joint at the knee. Now, what's very interesting about this is there is an extra flat back here. You see, it's naturally kind of loose, but I like the way that acts as a panel. And then here in the side, at the thigh, you can see through that thigh. I have never seen a kit that leaves an open gap like that. That wasn't like a weird shoulder handle thing on the SIEG kits. I don't know what that's all about. This is definitely the coolest of the three. And of course, the foot. The foot doesn't have a lot of side to side. It gets a lot more up and down than anything. It's a very good boy. For being a bad boy, it's a very good boy. When I bought it, I thought it was one of the good guys. But I asked, when I bought it, I hadn't seen the movie yet. So it's like, put that to the side. Your boy comes with the standard two closed fists. Now, something that happened before setting up was when I took a fist out to switch it back, there is a cuff at the wrist here that can pop off if you're not mindful, and it might just catch on the pegs for the hands. You get two very sharp, very spiky hands, regular old ball joint. You play with it a little too much, it'll pop out, but it's fine. It looks very skeletal, very monstrous, very cool. And then you get, with it, not one, not two, but four saw blades. Each spike is detailed and individualized. It's great. You get two, I guess, regular metallic, you know, I'm gonna mess you up chainsaws, and then the heated chainsaws, which look a whole lot better. Now, I do want to note, on this manual, here in the middle, it has the black on the inside, and then the heated part on just the spikes. So, you could, A, get really risky and kit bash the two together, or B, paint it. Which is the only time I'm really going to suggest painting on any one of these three. Now, as for the attachment, it's not a replacement like Gypsy. You pop off this wrist armor here. Very neat, very clean, very simple. Get that in there. Then you'll line this back up, sandwich it right on top, and have yourself a nice day. And you get an unobstructed full bend still. The only effect parts it came with are for the eye mask, and then these parts, the parts for the saw blades. Everything else. I've never worked with a kit that was one solid color. Like, I've never even seen them, not since, like, the first grade OG. Like, the first run of the Grandpa Gundam. Now, you know what? I left them in the box. I don't even want to get them out. I'm so mad at these stickers. I will say that for a kit that is designed to be only this, well, no, actually, now that I think about it, I don't know what JPT means, but it's the runner that are the polycaps, as it were. This use the least number of these polycaps. Gypsy Avenger used them all, and Bracer Phoenix left two behind. And also, he has a plate that goes in the booty to cover up the band hole. And then these. These again. This is where I discovered that these stickers were garbage. Like, these are all the tiniest of markings, and whatever is going on between the plastic and the glue, the sticker stickiness on these, it don't work. I've got like five of them on here, and I spent a good hour just on those five, getting them to stay in place and stay where they're supposed to be. They just don't. So, like the others, into the void with you. But that is literally this kit's one downside. ZEON says fund this bad boy. Fund it. Fund it, mass produce it. This, in my opinion, is the best of the three. It may not be your favorite, it may not be the hero, but of these three, it is certainly the best. But with that, we conclude this month, I guess. This month of Pacific Rim reviews. Stay tuned for every Wednesday is Gunpla Reviews. Or something. And as always, SIEG, ZEON.